Hello all, I'm Jared Counts from KUHF Radio. A lot more happens in film during the year than just a summer blockbuster opening, or even the small art film with awards buzz. Houston has a thriving film community, including multiple festivals and over 100 screens showing everything from silent classics to the newest Bollywood film to low-budget experiments at the Aurora Picture Show. Some of that takes some real driving to find, but at any given moment, you can find one of those films playing at the Rice Cinema. More than just another place to show movies, though, Rice Cinema is an integral part to Houston film and to the Houston film community. A host and screening room for numerous festivals, Rice also makes a concerted effort to find local and independent films to screen which you may love but would never have heard of otherwise. It's safe to say that there would be no Rice Cinema without Charles Dove. Charles has been running Rice Cinema nearly single-handedly for almost 2 decades now, providing Houston with one of its best alternate screening rooms and local cinema with one of its best outlets. Houston film would not be the same without Rice Cinema, and Rice Cinema would not be the same without Charles Dove. It is the Houston Film Critics Society's great honor to present the first 2010 award for Outstanding Achievement in Cinema to Mr. Charles Dove.
I'd like to thank a couple of people. Okay.
I'd like to thank especially the people I work with. You know, it's not really any individual effort. It's a team effort. And I want to thank Rachel Boyle and Hamid Nafisi and Brian Huberman, who hired me. And I also want to thank people at Swamp, Mary Lampe, Michelle Moore, all the great people there. And I also want to thank a guy who's no longer with us. His name is Michael Myron. And he was a good friend of mine. He died a couple of years ago, and he was the technical director of the cinema for many years, and he was a student at Rice and all these other things. So I want to thank all of you, and thanks very much to the society.
Your average film critic will see anywhere from 1 to 200 films each year. Some of them are good, some of them aren't so good, and some of them are great. Film critics, being the opinionated people we are, there's a lot of disagreement about which are which, but somehow each year we whittle those 100-some-odd films down to the 10 best films of the year. Of those 10, the 5 we're going to show you today represent the very best of film for 2010. The first of our top 5 nominees for Best Picture sounds like it could be, even should be, unwatchable. A film with essentially one actor stuck in one location, unable to move, unable to converse with anyone but himself for 90 minutes. In 2003, while hiking through Blue John Canyon in Utah, Aaron Ralston fell into a slot canyon and landed with his arm trapped beneath a boulder, unable to escape or call for help. He remained trapped in that canyon for 127 hours. Though it's far shorter than that, Danny Boyle's harrowing adaptation of Ralston's memoir makes you feel every moment of his ordeal, the desperation, the alienation, the regret for choices made and their consequences. And above it all, the unending, unconquerable will to survive.
Thank you. Afternoon, everybody. My name is Daniel Carlson. There's an old saying that half of the film experience is the music you hear, the score itself. The music that subtly creates the mood and the tone of the film without the audience even being aware of it. Even silent films had musical scores, which remain, in a way, the best sound effect possible for a movie. The best scores stick in your head long after you leave the theater, and we've had some great ones this year. And without any further ado, here are the nominees for Best Score.
Best Original Score. Carter Burwell, True Grit. John Powell, How to Train Your Dragon. A.R. Rahman, 127 Hours. Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross, The Social Network. Hans Zimmer, Inception.
Said out loud. The winner of the HFCS Award for Best Score is Hans Zimmer for Inception.
Hello, everyone. My name is Chris Solomon. If scores accentuate storytelling, the nominees for Best Original Song take the next step to becoming storytelling mechanisms in their own right, encapsulating soaring emotions in a way that may not sound right. The character just says it, but it's perfect when sung. This year's nominees, ranging from old-fashioned musical ballads to crunchy, distortion, heavy power chord rock, not only perfectly encapsulate their films and in 3 minutes and no less, they just sound great on their own. This year's nominees for Best Original Song are...
Best Original Song. If I Rise, from 127 Hours. Shine, from Waiting for Superman. The Clap, from Get Him to the Greek. We Are Sex Bob-omb, from Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. You Haven't Seen the Last of Me, from Burlesque.
And the winner is We Are Sex Bob-omb from Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Although we couldn't be here in person, we were able to get a message from Edgar Wright, the director of Scott Pilgrim vs. the World.
Hello, Houston. This is Edgar Wright speaking from London. You are officially the coolest film critics in the country because you have awarded Sex Bob-omb Best Song for We Are Sex Bob-omb. Obviously, this isn't the award. There is no award, but I just wanted to have something in my hands. I'm very, that song is very dear to me, and I'm really thrilled that you picked it, because when I heard Beck's demo of the song, which is pretty much what you hear in the movie, I knew that that had to be our opening titles. And whenever I introduce the film, if I haven't got time to watch the movie, I always make sure I stay until that song is finished, because it excites me to see it and hear it on the big screen. So I'm glad that you felt the same way. And like I said, you're the coolest. Thank you very much.
Without organization, even the most creative of groups and projects would simply fall apart. Structure and adhering to principles and goals strengthen the bonds that allow creativity to flow. It is these principles that have allowed the Houston film industry to reach a much higher level. And for that, the Houston film community owes a debt of thanks to Mr. Hector Luna. In January of 2008, Hector Luna created and founded C47 Houston Magazine. His desire was to bring continuity to those folks who make up our local filmmaking industry. His mission was simple. He wanted to create a viable and lasting mark on the industry here in Houston, using the local talent that is just as capable here as anywhere else in the nation. Without question, he has achieved his goal. By providing an outlet for everyone in the local industry, from actors, directors, and cinematographers, C47 Houston and Hector Luna have created a vision of success for all to follow that has allowed filmmakers to meet each other, work together, and create a cohesiveness within the local industry. An accomplished filmmaker and I were in a conversation just last month, and he commented to me that if you're here in Southern Texas, there are two things that you need to stay on top of everything that has to do with the industry. One is a subscription to Variety. And the second, and this comment comes from Mr. Rodriguez in Austin, is a copy of C47 magazine. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the Houston Film Critics Society, second, but not least, Achievement in Film Award winner, Mr. Hector Luna.
This is really not about me. This is about the magazine, and this is about the film community here in Houston. And in Texas, I've strived to talk to a lot of the filmmakers, independent filmmakers, TV makers, the actors, the talent, the people behind the camera, to focus on them. And this is what this is all about. And this is what my magazine is all about. And I think Houston is a great place to make movies, and I hope it continues. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon. I am Travis Lemons, writer and editor of Inside Post Movies, an online website. There have been a lot of films made about the creative process of all shapes and sizes and genres and themes, but they all seem to agree on one thing. You have to be crazy to go into the arts, or at the very least, it helps a lot. Darren Aronofsky's Black Swan takes that idea and runs with it, turning the quest for artistic perfection into a harrowing psychological thriller, visually arresting, endlessly inventive. And the Black Swan asks us the same question every artist must at some point ask themselves. Is all of this really worth it? And with that, a clip from the film. ¶¶